they asked us if we had a very specific thing called a redwood cookie, and we didn't even know what that is. And I guess it's a sample of a tree core. And I said, well, no, but we have some other specimens related to redwoods. And they decided they would like to include some things in the exhibit.
Sprays of foliage with some cones. There was a collection, I believe, by Jepson and one by Lincoln Constance that looked like good specimens to them. The other was a box from a lumber company. Jepson visited a lumber company, got samples of heartwood, sapwood, and bark, and also some field notebooks of Jepson's.
This collection is one of the specimens shown over here. This one here.
So we thought that anything coming from here in with Bancroft materials should probably be frozen before it goes out, just for the small possibility that it would have any infestation of these beetles. We have a minus 30 degree blast freezer that, and we routinely freeze things for a week in there. There are about 2.2 million plant specimens in the herbarium. Drugstore beetles and cigarette beetles, they eat the plants and they deposit what we politely call frass where the plants were, and they can take an entire herbarium sheet and turn it into excrement. Anything that comes in the door we freeze, or we let them come to room temperature, and then they can go into herbarium cases in the collection, or in this unusual case they're going to go uphill to the Bancroft. So I think it's natural a lot of us in the herbarium with our interest in plants are also interested in conservation, and that's the point of the exhibit. So, you know, you look at these plant specimens and you just kind of get more interested in plants than you were before. So it's kind of contagious, and we're hoping people will catch that.